All right, so today we're going to use Mother's Clay Bar 2.0. We got it soaking in our bucket of soap water here, so we can use that as lubricant to clay bar the car. Currently, I washed the car late last night in the shade, and it's early morning now. We're going to try to get this done here in just an hour or so, but we're gonna start with a reflection photo here. You can see there's not much of one. And yeah, we're just going to lube it up, clay bar the entire car. This is a 2012 Chrysler 200. We're actually giving it to our niece here in a couple of months for her 16th birthday. First car, nothing special. It was a daily driver to and from work. And yeah, it's been a pretty significant rear end collision. That was repaired about 8 years ago. Well, 6 years ago rather. And yeah, the two doors over here had to be replaced more recently. That's why the one door has a chrome door handle, which we're not really too concerned about. Like I said, it's a first car for a 16-year-old. So I'm pretty sure she'll be happy just to have wheels and get around. But we are going to make sure it's nice and clean, get a nice coat of wax on it afterwards. And yeah, you'll get to see the process. Thanks for watching. Super smooth on areas that have been done. You can possibly hear this. And it'll literally level out the paint itself. The 2.0 here, I really do prefer over the traditional clay bar. It's got a nice smooth flat surface. Fingers here, super user easy. And again, you can really hear it tearing up the paint here. Not tearing up the paint, but taking off that layer of stuff that's in your paint that you can't see, but causes the paint not to shed the water quite as well as it should. We're gonna get a much nicer finish just by doing this. A little bit of elbow grease and some time. It's really all it takes. It'll be looking better than new by the time we're done. Getting a little dry here. We'll some more wet water. Get over to the other half of the hood. And set you back up over over here. Now, I've already done the driver's side of the hood, that's why it didn't take very long.
I like to go panel by panel just to, so that I know what I've already done. Just work my way around the car. Let's do contours. It's a little gun, that's not gonna hurt, I guess. And that's horrible. Except for unlike a regular one, these can still rinse off. So you don't have any fine dirt. It's going to scratch your paint now. So we got some of that road grime. Scratch that off with our finger. Also a good practice just to get intimate with your car. That way you know, especially if you have a newer car, you can, if you do this often, you can make sure you're keeping track of any scratches, paint chips, and take care of them right away so you don't begin to get that rust. For this car, again, it's too late. This was never that car. Bought it used to beat up on and drive back and forth to work.
You can already observe the difference with the water, the way it sheets off of the fender and just kind of accumulates on the door back there. You can see a huge difference. I mean, that's just, it's all the contaminants and dust in your paint that the water's sticking to there as opposed to sheeting off.
Straight back and forth and up and down. And I'll have to water sheet off this time. Here on the glass. up right where we left off.
Damn tick.
I don't know why the water's pooling there, so I'm gonna give it another hit, but again, I think that's just gonna require some wet sanding and polishing. That noise is all splash guard, piece of vinyl down here. Thank you.
All right, so I won't bore you anymore with wiping and wiping with the Mother's 2.0 clay bar there. Like I said, amazing product. This is my third vehicle I've done now with it, and I absolutely love the way that it works. Way better than traditional white wax, in my opinion. So I'm gonna finish up this portion of it, and when I go to put wax on her, we will get back with you. Thanks. All right, well, I've went around and clay barred the entire car all the way around. It's dried off. Again, got that spot there. Looks pretty horrible. I'm gonna use Turtle Wax Ceramic Polish and Hybrid all-in-one with the awesome, super cheap Harbor Freight 5-inch? 6-inch palm polisher. It's worked pretty good for me in the past. I have a high-speed one, but I really prefer not to use it, especially, again, we're giving this car to a 16-year-old. I'm sure it's going to get beat up. So, here we go. Thank you. I'm not gonna lay that on the gun for you. So I feel pretty confident with this wax. I can get quite a bit on there, and even though I am in direct sunlight, it's not hot outside by any means right now, so we're not too concerned about that. It'll start to haze up. I'll take the dry cloth to it, and then we'll see what kind of reflection we can get back in it. Super crystal. Clear though.
You know we did a good job cleaning it because our rag for a final wipe is still super clean. So between the mother's clay bar, the wash last night, we got all the contaminants off of our paint. And now we're just back to protecting it.
Let's see how our reflection's looking. A bit harder to see now in the direct sunlight. Bring her around over here down to the side. Let me show you. Looks pretty good to me.